Hey guys, welcome back. This is Bernard from the BTNHD, and today is all about deploying Windows 10 version 2004 within SCCM. So let's get started. All right, so it's all about deploying the latest version of Windows 10 within SCCM. Make sure that your SCCM is fully up to date. I believe you could only deploy Windows 10 2004 with SCCM 2002. As always, make sure you are running the latest Windows ADK and the latest Windows PE. Within my environment, I was running an old version, and so I need to remove it. So the first thing that I did was select the Windows PE, clicked on uninstall, hit yes here. It's going to start removing everything, and it's done. And then from here, I'm going to click on close and do the same thing. Pick your Windows ADK, click on uninstall. You're going to get this. Pick uninstall, click next. It's going to remove it. Once it's done, bam, click on close. Open up your favorite browser, and you're going to go to this website. And then from here, you're going to download the latest Windows ADK and the Windows PE. I dropped everything inside the desktop, and super simple. Let's double click on the ADK setup. From here, click on next. Pick your poison. I clicked on no. Clicked on next. Accept the license and terms. I left everything as the default and then clicked on next. It's going to start installing the features and you're done. And then click on close. Same thing. Double click on that ADK Windows PE. You're going to get this. Click on next. Pick your poison here. Click next. Accept the license and terms. You only have one feature, which is the big one. This is 5.5 gigs, and then click on install. It's going to start installing the features, and you're done. If you go inside programs and features, you're going to see that you have the latest version, which is currently 10.1.19.041.1. Get your hands on the latest Windows 10 2004. Once you grab your copy, we are going to double click on it. And the reason why I'm double clicking on it is because I want to mount it into my DVD drive, which is the F drive. And I'm going to go inside my network share, which is located within my SCCM. And I have an OSD folder, which is broken down to OS, OS images, and another folder called Windows 10 x64. And I broke it down by, you know, the version. So I created a folder called V2004. And I double clicked inside that V2004 folder, and everything inside the F drive is dragged and dropped inside that folder. Once everything is copied over to that folder, I'm going to select the address. I'm going to right click on it and copy it because I'm going to need that UNC path soon. Now we're going to open up your SCCM console. And like I said before, one of the core requirements is that you have to have SCCM 2002. So on the upper left side of the console, I'm going to click on the menu and I'm going to do About Configuration Manager because I just want to show you guys that I am running version 2002. Now, because we installed and updated iWindows ADK, we need to upgrade our boot image, right? So we need to go inside Software Library, and within here, open up Operating Systems and then go inside Boot Images. I'm going to update my boot image x64, so I'm going to select it. Right click on it. I'm going to pick on update distribution points. From here, you want to check reload the boot image with the current Windows PE version. Click on next. Next. It's going to do its thing. This process takes a while. Once it's completed, you're going to get this. Awesome. We're going to close it. Once you updated your boot image, we are going to go inside the operating system image node. We are going to right click on it. Pick add operating system image. You're going to get the wizard. From here, we are going to click on browse. And that path that we copied, we are going to paste it in there and we're going to open it and we are going to navigate inside sources. And within sources, we are going to locate the install.wim file and then click on open. I am going to check extract a specific image because I don't want all the images imported within my system. So I'm going to click on the image index drop down menu and I'm going to pick my flavor, which would be number 3. Make sure you pick your build, either 86 or 64. I'm going to pick 64 and click on the drop down menu to pick your language, which would be for me, English. Once you set all that stuff up, click on next. Change the name, which this is what I gave it. Click on next. Click on next. It's going to start importing that single image. And once it's done, you get this. And from here, we are going to select our new Windows operating system image and we are going to right click on it. And we are going to do is distribute the content. Click next here. We're going to click on add and we're going to pick on DP and pick your DP. I have two of them. I am going to select the primary one for this example and click OK. Click next here. Nice little summary. Click next and then okay. And then bam. Now, before I do anything, if you look at the very bottom, if you have your image selected at the very bottom, you're going to see a nice little summary and content status. You see how it is yellow in progress? I like to make sure that it changes green. Once it changed green, that means you're good to go. Once that's done, we need to go inside task sequence because now we need to create our task sequence. So I'm going to right click on the task sequence node and then click on create a task sequence. You're going to get the wizard. From here, I'm going to leave the default. Click next here. Give your task sequence a name. Click on browse and pick your boot image. I'm going to pick the boot image X64. That is the one that we kind of updated. And click OK. I read a lot of articles online. It looks like the best approach is to run as a high performance power plan. So I just gave it a check to see how, if that actually works out, to see if the deployment process changes, like the speed wise. So we're going to click next here. Your image package, we are going to pick browse. I'm going to pick my package and then click OK. I don't need to pick the index because again, there's only one index with this image. I'm going to enable the account for a local administrative password, provide your password and confirm it. And the last thing that I did was I unchecked configure task sequence with BitLocker. Okay, depending on your environment, you might have to leave that checked off. But for me, I disabled it. And then I clicked on next here. From here, you're able to join a domain. Once you're done, click on next. From here, set your configuration manager client settings. Click next. If you're going to do any migration, change it or leave it as is. I think I disabled all that stuff within my environment. And then once you're done, click on next. Are you including software updates? Again, I can't really tell you guys do this, do that, do that. This is really up to you. But once you set everything up within your environment, just click on next. Do you have any apps that you need to install? Once you add all your apps, just click on next. A nice little summary, click next, and then done, you're completed, and then close it. Now, the last thing that we need to do is select our new task sequence, right click on it, and we need to deploy it. You're going to get the deploy software wizard. From here, we are going to click on browse. You're going to get this nice little warning. Just click on OK. Pick your container. My container is going to be all unknown computers. Click OK, click next here. Now I want to make this task sequence available to the following. So hit that drop down menu and for my environment, I'm going to do only media and Pixie and then click on next. Scheduling, I left it as the default, click next here. The user experience, left it as the default, click next. Alerts, default, next. For the DP settings, next again. Summary, next. Once everything is completed, all green check marks, that is always a good thing. You could close it and then test out your deployment. Now, at the very end of the video, you're going to see like a speed video. Do not stop the video. You're going to see the process of me actually creating a virtual machine, Pixie booting inside that virtual machine, logging into my SCCM, picking this task sequence out and letting it ride. And at the very end, you're going to see a successful deployment using Windows 10 version 2004 within SCCM. So that's awesome. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to hit that like button. Also, do not forget about punch, elbow, and smashing that subscribe button to get the latest and greatest from this guy. And I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out. Again, don't stop the video. Continue watching. All right?